Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about a dividend discount model. I'll set it up with an example. So let's read the example, and then I'll explain the dividend discount model further. A stock pays a dividend at the end of each year. The dividend at the end of the current year will be 2, and each subsequent dividend is 3% more than its preceding one. So I've got dividends that form a geometric progression here. It says the price of the stock 10 years from the beginning of the current year will be CapEx. At that time, the annual effective interest rate is assumed to be 10%, and we want to determine CapEx using the dividend discount model. So this is what our timeline is going to look like. I've got dividend at the end of this year is going to be 2, and then subsequent dividends increase by 3%. So I got, again, this geometric progression of dividends. And I've got CapEx is going to be the price of the stock 10 years from the beginning of the current year. So that will be at time 10. Is when CapEx, my valuation date then is at time 10. And when it says, when the problem says the dividend discount model, what that's giving me is, what that's telling me to do is to just take the present value of the future dividends. And that dividend discount model then is giving us a theoretical price of the stock, what we think the price of the stock will be 10 years from now. It's kind of a theoretical price. When you look at stock prices, there are market prices and theoretical prices. The market price is the price, you know, if you go buy the stock, how much you're going to pay. You're going to pay market price. Theoretical price may or may not be equal to market price. In fact, probably most of the time, theoretical price will not be equal to the market price. Okay, but this is what my timeline is going to look like. So let me move everything up just to get more room to work with here. And so I've got CapEx is the present value of the future dividends. Now, it's very clear that the dividends at time 1, the dividend at time 1 is 2, the dividend at time 2 is 2 times 1.03 and so forth. It's very clear that the dividends all the way up to time 10 are past dividends. I'm taking the present value of future dividends, so I don't need those. But now, what about that dividend at time 10? So I put that, highlighted that in blue, and the question is that a past, is that a past dividend or is a future dividend? So let's go back and read the problem a little bit more closely, and it says the dividends are paid at the end of each year. And so this dividend in blue right here is at the end of the 10th year. And then if I go back and read the problem, and the problem says the price of stock 10 years from the beginning of the current year, so when the 10 years later now, at 10 years from the beginning of the current year will be CapEx. So that CapEx is at the beginning of the next year. So that the dividend that's in blue is at the end of the previous year, and CapEx is at the beginning of the next year. So the dividend in blue is actually considered to be a past dividend. You can think of it as being like that dividend is being paid 1 second before midnight, and then I'm doing a calculation 1 second after midnight, and so that's going to be a past dividend. I'm not going to include that as part of my calculation when I'm computing the present value of the future dividends. So at this point, I want to compute the present value of those dividends. I'm considering the present value to be that time 10 value there, and so I guess technically it's more of a discounted value, but I want to take the discounted value of all those dividends at time 10, and that's what my answer is going to be. So it's a geometrically increasing perpetuity that I'm valuing. So it's just a two-step process. The first step is to value each payment. And so when I value the first dividend at time 10, I need to take that dividend amount, which is 2 times 1.03 to the 10th power, and discount that back one period, so I multiply that times V. I take that next dividend and multiply it times V squared. The V value, I was told that the interest rate is, I'm going to assume the interest rate at the time is 10%, so the V is a 1 over a 1.1, so I could put that in numerically. So this is all my step one. I'm just valuing each payment. Recognize that as the geometric series. To go from one term to the next, I'm going to have to multiply by 1.03 and divide by 1.1. So the common ratio there is a 1.03 divided by 1.1. So I've got this geometric series with that common ratio, and the next step is to recognize that the value of a geometric series is the first term divided by 1 minus the ratio. So I'll plug in the first term to divide by 1 minus the ratio, do some simplifications, or just do the numeric calculations, and you'll see that you get a 38.4 is what I get as the price of the stock 10 years, at the beginning of the year, 10 years from now, and using the dividend discount model. So dividend discount model, again, just means take the dividends and take, increase them or do whatever they tell you within the problem. In this problem, they told me they were going to be forming a geometric progression, and then just take the present value of the dividends. And that gives you the theoretical price of the stock. That's all the dividend discount model is. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about other ways that you might see the problem. It might not give you the dividends directly. Sometimes dividends might be given to you as a percentage of earnings. And so the total dividends would be whatever that percentage is of total earnings. They might say dividends are 2% of earnings. So the total dividends will be 2% of whatever the total earnings are. And for companies, you have total earnings, then you have what's called earnings per share. Earnings per share is exactly what it is. You take the total earnings and you divide that by the number of shares of stock that there are, and then you have how much the earnings per share is. And then the dividend per share would just be equal to the percentage of whatever percentage, 2% or whatever they tell you, times earnings per share. So that's what dividend per share would be. And then the dividend discount model states that for a stock that pays future dividends, the theoretical price or the price per share is just equal to the present value of the future dividends per share. So take present value of future dividends per share, that's what the price per share would be. That's the dividend discount model. Okay, so that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one.